والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد النبي العربي الأمي الأمين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. All praises due to Allah, peace and blessings be upon the Messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Welcome again in our weekly class explaining fiqh, jurisprudence, how to understand the deen. And last time we started discussing salah, and we said in fact that salah is really, really important. It is the most important pillar in our religion at all. After declaring shahada, after saying ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna muhammadan rasulullah, the most important thing that you should do is salah. You cannot make salah ever. You don't have any excuse to miss salah. You know, for example, in zakah, az-zakah, giving zakah is one of the pillars of Islam. But you can miss giving zakah if you don't have this property, if you don't have enough money to give zakah, right? Fasting, as-siyam, also you can have some excuses when, if you are sick, if you are traveling. Yes, after Ramadan you will make it up, no problem. But you have some excuses when you are making fasting. And for pilgrimage, you should be able to go to pilgrimage physically and financially. But for salah, you don't have any excuses. You cannot miss salah. This is the most important pillar in our religion. And as our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, that أَوَّلُ مَا يُحَاسَبُ عَلَيْهِ الْعَبْدُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ الصَّلَاةِ. The first thing that you will be held accountable and responsible in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the first thing you will be asked about is your salah. فَإِنْ صَلُحَتْ صَلُحَ عَمَلُهُ كُلُّهُ وَإِنْ فَسَدَتْ فَسَدَ عَمَلُهُ كُلُّهُ. So if you were performing your salah in your life and establishing it in the right way, in the prescribed times, it will facilitate your account before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It will help you pass this test, inshallah, and to enter the paradise. And if not, you are in big trouble, in fact. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from being those people. So salah. And you know that the last words that our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said before his death, as-salah, as-salah, keep preserving your salah, establish your salah, perform your salah. These are the last words that our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said before he died, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So, and also last time we talked about some rules. In case you missed it, a quick revision. When can you raise your hand in salah? At the first takbirah, takbiratul ihram, you raise your hand, match to your shoulders like this, Allahu Akbar. And yes, and when you go to ruku', this is the second position. And again, when you say sami' Allahu liman hamida, stand up. These are just the three positions or the three times you raise your hand in your salah. Okay? When takbirat al-ihram, the first takbirah, immediately after making iqama, and when you go to ruku', and when you say sami' Allahu liman hamida. And again, after finishing your first tashahud in the second rak'ah, and you go to the third rak'ah, also you raise your hand. Okay? So, another rule we discussed last time quickly, if you are making salah for tahiyyatul masjid or sunnatul salah, and you listen that your brother is making iqama or imam already started salah, what will you do? Yes, if you just at the first rak'ah, if you sin at the first rak'ah, you leave your salah and to join your brothers in Salat al-Jama'ah. Because Salat al-Jama'ah is fard, it's better than Salat al-Nafila or Tahiyyat al-Masjid. But if you are in the second rak'ah, you are about to finish your salah, you can make it something quickly, and also you join Salat al-Jama'ah. Okay, just to feel it. Can I join this salah, Salat al-Jama'ah? Can I catch takbiratul ihram, the first takbirah? If, for example, I am in the second rak'ah, I am in the second sujood, in the second rak'ah, So I will sit to say التحيات لله الصلاة الطيبة, and that's it. And then I make salam, salam alaikum rahmatullah, salam alaikum rahmatullah, and I will catch jama'ah, no problem. But if you are still in the first rak'ah, if you're still in the first rak'ah of your salat in nafila or tahiyat al masjid, just leave your salah without making salam. Don't say salamu alaikum, salamu alaikum. Just leave your nafila, your sunnah, and join salat al jama'ah without making salam. We make assalamu alaikum rahmatullah, assalamu alaikum rahmatullah, just when we end our prayer in a normal way. After completing your salah, you must say assalamu alaikum rahmatullah, assalamu alaikum rahmatullah. But if you leave your salah for a reasonable reason like this, just leave it and go away and go directly to salat al jama'ah without making salam. Okay? And the third rule, if you enter the masjid before Salat al-Maghrib, before Adhan al-Maghrib, what will you do?
Sit down.
Don't pray Tahiyat al-Masjid at this time. Okay? Because at this time, our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, inshallah we will come to this point now, but quickly don't make Tahiyat al-Masjid before Salat al-Maghrib and don't pray after Salat al-Asr. Okay? So, MashaAllah, sometimes we have children here, we have little kids. What is the rule for little kids and for children? Salah is not obligatory for them. Salah is not obligatory for little children and little kids. But it's preferable to train them, to combine them to the masjid, to bring them to the masjid, in order to train them to salah, so that when they grow old, inshallah, they can make salah without these hardships, without these difficulties. Okay? About the time limited to each salah. Salat al-Dhuhr, for example, the limited time for Salat al-Dhuhr till Salat al-Asr. Okay? And Salat al-Asr till Salat al-Maghrib. I mean in between Salat al-Asr and Salat al-Maghrib, you can pray the Fariidah, Salat al-Asr itself. And Salat al-Maghrib also, you have this area just till Salat al-Isha. And Salat al-Isha till Salat al-Fajr. Okay, if you miss Salat Jama'ah, you can pray at this time. But for Salat al-Fajr specifically, you have just a little area of time till the sun rises. So the time for Salat al-Fajr ends at this point in time when the sun rises. Okay? So now we say now that it is a limited area, but it's not preferable to delay Salat al-Fariidah. You have to catch Salat al-Fariidah in Jama'ah or at its prescribed time. Don't delay Salat al-Fariidah. But if you miss it for any reasonable reason, no problem. You should make it and you have this area of time. Even if you miss this Salah and the next Salah comes, also you have to make up your Salah. We said that you don't have any excuses to leave any single Salah. Every single salah you will be held accountable and responsible before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for your salawat. That's why our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, "Man nasiya salatan falyusalli idha dhakaraha." Whoever forgets any salah, he should do it when he remember it. Whoever forgets any salah, any fariidah, you should do it. You should perform this salah immediately when you remember it. Some people say, today I missed Salat al-Asr. Now we already prayed Salat al-Isha. Okay, I will pray Salat al-Asr, inshallah, tomorrow after Salat al-Asr. Okay, that's okay. But do you guarantee that you will still alive? You're still alive till tomorrow, till Salat al-Asr? No. That's why our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, فَلْيُصَلِّ إِذَا ذَكَرَهَا. Immediately, when you remember that you missed one salah or more than salah, pray it. Pray it at this time. Directly, quickly. Because we don't guarantee our life, in fact. Okay? But for Salat al-Isha, in fact, it's narrated that our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, sometimes he was delaying Salat al-Isha. He was delaying Salat al-Isha sometimes. So we have the choice whether to pray it at its prescribed time or to delay it till about the half of the night. Maybe 2 or 3 hours after Isha, This in this area of time you can pray Salat al-Isha, no problem at all. Okay, but for all salawat, as a general rule, you are not required, or you don't have to delay your salah, but to catch it, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah An-Nisa, إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ كَانَتْ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ كِتَابًا مَوْقُوتًا, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prescribed a specific time for every salah, for each salah. You have to pray Salat al-Dhuhr when you listen to Adhan al-Dhuhr, or when Salat al-Dhuhr, when this time comes, and Salat al-Asr, and Salat al-Maghrib, and so on. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he prescribed salah at the first time directly to our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he prescribed 50 prayers. In the journey of Al-Isra' wal-Mi'raj, when our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had this journey to the seven heavens, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prescribed 50 salah on our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and accordingly on his ummah, on all of us. And our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam started to make dua to Allah. Ya Allah, O Allah, my ummah cannot pray 50 times a day. My ummah is weak, they cannot pray 50 times a day. He started making dua again and again to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it easy for us. And then he said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so pray 5 times a day and I will multiply it by 50 times. Now you are praying, you pray just 5 times a day and you get the reward of 50 prayers. And besides, you know that coming to Salat al-Jama'ah in the masjid is multiplied by 27 times. So when you calculate it, subhanAllah, it's how big reward is this? So please keep preserving your Salat on its time. Come to the masjid, join Jama'ah, join your brothers in Salat al-Jama'ah. And for the virtue and the quality and the importance of Salat al-Jama'ah, Sayyiduna ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu says, may Allah be pleased with him, رَأَيْتُ الرَّجُلَ يُؤْتَى بِهِ يُهَادَى بَيْنَ الرَّجُلَيْنِ حَتَّى يُقَامَ فِي الصَّفِّ. I saw a man coming to the masjid supported by two men, two brothers. They support him. He cannot even walk. He's very sick, or even he's very old. He cannot walk, supported by two men. Why? To come to Salat al-Jama'ah. Until he comes and being set up in the row, you know, as if they carry this man and put him into the row itself. But he cannot miss Salat al-Jama'ah. This is the virtue and the importance of Salat al-Jama'ah. That's why every day and every opportunity we have, usually we ask people to come to Salat al-Jama'ah in Salat al-Maghrib. Alhamdulillah, every day I see a lot of people in Salat al-Maghrib, at least 7 persons. Alhamdulillah, we reach 12 and 13 persons in weekends, and this is very good. Inshallah, we will give you some gifts, inshallah. Brother Abdul Qadir will give you some gifts, inshallah. Okay, and for Salat al-Fajr, Salat al-Fajr fi jama'ah is very important. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, man salla as-subha fi jama'atin fahuwa fi dhimmatillah. Whoever performs Salat al-Fajr in congregational prayer at the masjid, he is under the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the rest of the day. He is under the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the rest of the day. That's why you have to keep coming to the masjid to perform Salat al-Fajr or Salat al-Subh, both are the same, fi jama'ah, in congregational prayer. And going back to the times, you cannot pray or you cannot play unless you have this reasonable reason. After Salat al-Fajr, don't pray anything after Salat al-Fajr. And before Salat al-Dhuhr, maybe for half an hour, and after Salat al-Asr. Okay? In these times, there is no Salah. Don't make Salah. Unless you already missed the Faridah. For example, if I come to the masjid before Adhan al-Maghrib, and I already didn't pray Salat al-Asr, I have to pray it right now. When I say don't pray, meaning don't pray tatawwa. Some people come to the masjid, okay, I'll pray 2 rak'ahs for the sake of Allah. That's very good. But don't make these 2 rak'ahs after Asr or after Fajr. Okay? So now, this is the most important pillar in our religion. Alhamdulillah, I see a lot of people every day, and I hope that you, by the time inshallah will increase, you will invite people to come to the masjid, you will pass this information to all of people, you will convey the message of Allah and His Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as this is the duty of all persons, not just imam, not just shaykh, not just alim, not just ustad, and all this stuff, no. All people, كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ. You are the best ummah that brought to people. تَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَتَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ. All of you ordering what's good. يَأْمُرُوا بِالْمَعْرُوفِ. And all of you eradicating what's evil. وَتَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ. So it's the duty of all people, of all Muslims, to call for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to call for the deen, the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to invite people to the masjid. جزاكم الله خيرا. That's enough for today. If you have any question, inshallah, concerning salah or this part, yes.
Imam, I have one question.
Yeah.
If a person miss like more than one salah,
yeah,
for example, Zuhr and Asr, and it's time for Maghrib, how does he pay the salah?
Okay, the question is, if someone missed more than one salah, for example, Zuhr or Asr, and the time, and it's time for Maghrib, how can you pray this salawat? You will pray it in sequence. Okay? If you have already, if you are in Jama'ah, in Salat al-Maghrib, okay, pray Salat al-Jama'ah, and then pray Dhuhr, and then pray Salat al-Asr. Okay? Yes?
You said, don't pray after Salat al-Fajr, but there is Salat al-Ishraq and Salat al-Duha, some people pray.
Yeah, that's very good. Salat al-Duha, you mean. Okay, I mean, the area of time before Salat al-Fajr, till the sun rises. And after the sun rises, little time after sunrise, maybe 20 minutes, till Salatul Dhuhr, you have this area of time you can pray Salatul Duha. And Salatul Duha, in fact, has a lot of rewards. Yes. Is that okay? Inshallah, to pray it in sequence.
I have a question, but it could be a little bit complicated question. One time I was a witness.
Don't let it be complicated, inshallah. It will be.
I was a witness in a prayer, was Asr, as a matter of fact.
Yes.
And we were at the fourth rak'ah. As a matter of fact, we were sitting down with reciting the Ibrahimi.
Yes.
A group of people came in, didn't join us. They waited until the Imam said, Salamu alaikum, Salamu alaikum. They made a comma and made Salat al-Asr by themselves. The Imam kind of ridiculed them in a way. He said, don't do that.
Yes.
Because the second iqama for a Salat al-Jama'ah is no.
Yes, better for them to join the first jama'ah. They are not compared, you know. If inshallah their salah is right, no problem. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept. But if they join the first jama'ah, they will be rewarded inshallah for 27 times. Of course, they will not be like those who catch takbiratul ihram or like those who came at the first or second rak'ah, but they will be already catch the first jama'ah. So if they miss it at all and they came to the masjid, no problem. But don't wait until the imam says salamu alaykum and then start salah. That is not the correct way. The correct way. Jazakallahu khair. Yes.
Shia raising the hand for the takbirah, is that by your shoulder or behind your ears?
Both. But in fact, the majority is to raise your hand by your shoulder. That's better. But you know, in salah, inshallah, we'll come to a lot of issues concerning salah, in fact. Next time we'll start, inshallah, adhan. How to make adhan. So we'll have long time in salah. In salah, there are some physical actions, like raising hands, like when you're making dua in salat al-witr. These are physical actions. Even if you miss some of them, they will not affect your salah, in fact. But for the pillars, for standing, for making ruku'ah, for making sujood, you cannot miss one of them. When you miss the middle tashahud after the second rak'ah, you can make sujood al-sahw and your salah is correct, inshallah. So a lot of issues concerning salah, inshallah, will come to it. But they are physical. Don't worry about if you raise your hand by your shoulders or by your ears, like, no problem, inshallah.
One more question.
Yes.
We are on jama'ah with some guys in Maghrib time. On the third rak'ah, you know, when they do the ruku'ah, and they get up to do the sujood, they make dua. If this is, can be happening or not? I mean,
in Salat al-Farida, they made dua after the third rak'ah?
Yeah.
Okay, our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told that you can make dua in Salat al-Farida when there is a calamity, when there is a big problem that befalls your city, your reign. There is a big problem. We are involved in this crisis or in this calamity. In this state, we can make dua, but don't make dua in congregational like this. And the musallin says Ameen without this reasonable reason. But inshallah, it will not affect the salah. Inshallah, the salah is right, but it is not from the sunnah. I mean,
it's not from the sunnah.
Yes.
What about the people be equal the imam or be more forward from the imam?
MashaAllah, very crucial question. Okay. Imam, if you translate this word, you will translate it to the leader. And we should follow the leader. Right? So when you are praying, when you are following your imam, don't make your pillars, your ruku' and your sujood. Sometimes imam says Allahu Akbar when he going to sujood. You are not supposed to move until I put my forehead on the ground. Again, you are not supposed to move to go down until my forehead touch the ground. After that, you go to sujood. I think that's clear, right?
La tusawi wa la tasbiq.
Yes, la tusawi wa la tasbiq.
Sheikh, I have a question. This is the same matter. If you recite, the imam recite the fatwa, and we are behind him, after he's done reciting the fatwa, he's going to enter to the other surah or ayah. Do we should recite the fatwa as sayyam, or we recite the fatwa just when he recited?
When Imam recites Fatiha, you can recite with him. Or you can recite in this area of time, this space, this opportunity that Imam gives you. Both are right, inshallah. But as if in our masjid, you know, sometimes you have to go with the habits and the usual actions we are doing. They are okay. All of us are right, inshallah. But in our masjid, alhamdulillah, after Fatiha, usually I give you this opportunity. So just listen to Surah Al-Fatiha, and then when I keep silent and stop praying and ending Surah Al-Fatiha, you pray Surah Al-Fatiha, inshallah, I will start the next surah, inshallah. Okay, Zakumullah, yes.
I have a question. If you're away from home, and you have najasa came on your floor, and it's time to pray, do you delay your prayer until you get home, like for example, your floor? And najasa came on you at your floor. So do you pray with the najasa on?
Yes, what kind of najasa you mean?
Just regular najasa from the bathroom or just in general, najasa came on your clothes. So do you pray your prayer on time and repeat when you go home and leave?
No. Anyway, you don't have to pray your prayers twice. Anyway, you don't have to make your prayers twice. But we have some specific details in this case. In fact, if it is, I don't think that this najasa will be dry. I mean, if it is dry, you can rub it. If it is wet, you should wash it. All this stuff, inshallah, not for your case, because I think that when you are driving, maybe you are carrying your little boy or your little daughter, and all this stuff. So in this case, if you cannot clean this najasa, you have to wait. But if you pass by this gas station, if you have even a bottle of water, all this stuff, you can use it to remove this najasa. So we just wait. If we have or if we cannot remove this najasa, if we don't have any other way, okay. First, you start by removing this najasa from your clothes by water, by rubbing, and then by water. Whatever the kind of this impurity is, and if it is not allowed to you, you can wait. Yes. JazakumAllahu khairan. See you inshallah next time. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.